En el capítulo de hoy vamos a aprender inglés de manera natural con la ayuda del cuento de Ricitos de Oro y los Tres Osos. El método de inglés natural consiste en utilizar estrategias como la lectura, la mímica, los cuentos, la música y la repetición en periodos cortos para que el estudiante aprenda el lenguaje tal cual como lo haría un niño pequeño. En el cuento de hoy vamos a ir develando poco a poco el significado de cada párrafo, aprendiendo un nuevo vocabulario y gramática bajo la marcha. Al final de este video serás capaz de entender toda la lectura aún sin saber inglés. Once upon a time, there were three bears who lived together in a house of their own, in a wood. One of them was a little wee bear, and one was a middle-sized bear, and the other was a great big bear. Aun si no hayas entendido nada de este primer párrafo, vamos a ir develando el significado poco a poco. Vamos a empezar con la expresión once upon a time. Casi todos los cuentos empiezan con esta frase que quiere decir había una vez. There were three bears. ¿Qué tal si ahora introducimos estos tres elementos? Tres osos. Entonces ya sabemos que en el cuento hay tres osos. Y si vemos la palabra wood, que significa bosque, entonces empezamos a entender el contexto, que significa que en un bosque hay tres osos. Ahora, there were three bears. Habían tres osos. There were significa habían. Three significa tres y bears, como ya lo aprendimos, significa oso. Bears va a ser una palabra que vamos a ver mucho en esta lectura. Así que ya sabes que significan oso. Who lives together in a house of their own. Quienes vivían juntos en una casa suya, en una casa de su propiedad. Who live. Live es el pasado de live, que significa vivir. Quienes vivían, together, que significa juntos. In a house, en una casa. Of their own, una casa propia. In a wood, en el bosque. One of them was a little weaver. One significa un o uno. One of them significa uno de ellos. Was. Was es el pasado de is, que significa es. En este caso significa era o estaban. Uno de ellos era a little wee bear, un pequeño osito. And one was a middle-sized bear. Y otro era, ya vimos que was es el pasado de is, que significa era. A middle-sized bear, un osito de mediana estatura, un osito mediano. And the other was a great big bear. Y el otro era, de nuevo was, era a great big bear, un oso grande. They had each a bowl for their porridge, a little bowl for the little wee bear, and a middle-sized bowl for the middle-sized bear, and a great bowl for the great big bear. Ya sabemos entonces que bear significa oso. Ahora, en esta nueva parte vamos a introducir los términos bowl, porridge. Bowl, que significa tazón, y porridge, que significa avena. They had each a bowl. They significa ellos. Had es el pasado de have, que significa tenían. Each, cada uno, a bowl, Ya sabemos que bowl es tazón. Ellos tenían cada uno un tazón. For their porridge. Para su avena. For significa para. Their significa su. Porridge significa avena. A little bowl for the little wee bear. Un pequeño tazón para el osito pequeño. Un tazón mediano. A middle-sized bowl for the middle-sized bear. Un tazón mediano para el oso mediano. And a great bowl for the great bear. Y un tazón grande para el oso grande. And they had each a share to sit in. A little share for the little wee bear. And a middle-sized share for the middle-sized bear. And a great share for the great big bear. Ya sabemos entonces que cada uno de los osos tiene un tamaño. Y ya sabemos cómo se dice osito pequeño, osito mediano y osito grande. And they had each a chair. ¿Qué es chair? Una silla. Dijimos ya que they had significa ellos tenían. Each, cada uno. They had each a chair. Cada uno tenía una silla. To sit in. Una silla para sentarse. Sit es el verbo sentarse. A little chair for a little wee bear. Una pequeña silla para el osito pequeño. And a middle-sized chair for the middle-sized bear. Una silla mediana para el osito mediano. And a great chair for the great big bear. Y una silla grande para el oso grande. A little bed for the little wee bear. A middle-sized bed for the middle-sized bear. And a great bed for the great big bear. Vamos a introducir ahora el término bed, que significa cama. El little ya sabemos que significa pequeño. A little bed. Una pequeña cama, ¿para quién? For the little wee bear. A little bed for the little wee bear. One day, after they had made the porridge for their breakfast and poured it into the porridge bowls, they walked out into the wood while the porridge was cooling, that they might not burn their mouth by beginning too soon, for they were polite and brought up bears. Este es un párrafo un poquito más largo y complicado, pero vamos a ver qué sabemos hasta ahora. Had sabemos que significa tenían. Porridge sabemos que es avena. Ahora, breakfast significa desayuno. Cooling significa enfriando y burn significa quemar. Ya tenemos varias palabras que sabemos y ahora vamos a ver qué significan todas ellas juntas. One day, un día, after they had made the porridge. After significa después. They significan ellos. Had, ya sabemos qué significa habían. Made, hecho. One day after they had made the porridge. Un día después que habían hecho la avena. For their breakfast. Para su, ¿qué dijimos que significa breakfast? Desayuno. Para su desayuno. And poured into their porridge bowls. Y la vertieron en sus tazas de la avena. Ya sabemos que bowls es tazas. They walked out into the wood. Ellos se fueron a donde? Wood, ¿qué significa? Bosque. While the porridge was cooling. While significa mientras. The porridge was cooling. The porridge, ¿qué significa la avena? Was, ¿qué significa was? Se estaba Cooling, enfriando. Se fueron al bosque mientras la avena se estaba enfriando. That they might not burn. Para que así ellos no se quemaran. Their mouth, no se quemaran sus bocas. By beginning too soon. Por no empezar muy temprano. Beginning significa empezar. For they were polite, well brought up bears. Porque ellos eran unos osos muy educados. And while they were away, a little girl called Goldilocks, who lived at the other side of the wood and had been sent on an errand by the mother, passed by her house and looked in at the window. Ahora vamos a introducir otro vocabulario más. Window, que significa ventana, y Goldilocks, que significa ricitos de oro. And while they were away, y mientras ellos estaban lejos, where es el pasado de is, en plural. They were, no podemos decir they was, tenemos que decir they were, ellos estaban away. Antes de proseguir con la lectura, quiero recordarles que tenemos en este canal un curso completo de inglés conversacional para principiantes, al cual los invito a ver para que adquieran la base necesaria con el cual podrán mejorar muchísimo su inglés. Y allí van a encontrar toda la estructura gramatical y el vocabulario necesario para despegar su inglés. A little girl called Goldilocks. A little, ya sabemos que es pequeño. A little girl, una pequeña niña, called Goldilocks, llamada Goldilocks, who lived at the other side of the wood. Quien vivía, lived, el pasado de live. Ya dijimos que es el verbo vivir. Quien vivía at the other side, al otro lado, of the wood. Wood significa bosque, al otro lado del bosque. And had been sent on an errand by her mother. Había sido enviada errante por su madre. Mother significa madre. Passed by the house. Pasó por la casa. And looked in at the window. Y miró por la ventana. And then she peeped in at the keyhole, for she was not at all a well brought up little girl. Then, seeing nobody in the house, she lifted the latch. And then, y entonces, she peeped in. Ella se asomó at the keyhole, por el hueco de la puerta. For she was not at all a well brought up little girl. Porque ella was not, ella no era, she was not at all, para nada. Ella no era para nada a well brought up little girl, una niña bien educada. Then, entonces, seeing nobody in the house, no viendo a nadie en la casa, she lifted the latch. Ella levantó el portillo. Lifted es el pasado de lift, que significa levantar. Ella levantó el portillo. She lifted the latch. The door was not fastened because the bears were good bears who did nobody any harm and never suspected that anybody would harm them. So Goldilocks opened the door and went in. The door was not fastened. The door significa la puerta. Was not. Ya dijimos que was es el pasado de is, que significa era. The door was not. La puerta no estaba fastened. Estaba ajustada. Because, dijimos que significa porque. The bears, los osos, were, eran good bears. Porque los osos eran buenos osos. Who did nobody any harm? Quienes no le hacían a nadie ningún daño. Harm significa daño. I never suspected that anybody would harm them. I never, y nunca, suspected, sospechaban, that anybody would harm them, que alguien podría hacerles daño. So, Goldilocks opened the door and went in. So, significa entonces. Goldilocks, Ricitos de Oro, opened, abrió, the door, la puerta, and went in. Goldilocks, Ricitos de Oro, abrió la puerta y entró. And well pleased she was when she saw the porridge on the table. If she had been a well brought up little girl, she would have waited till the bears came home, and then perhaps they would have asked her to breakfast. Vamos a introducir nuevo vocabulario como table, que significa mesa, y waited, que significa esperaba. Es el pasado de wait, que significa esperar. And well pleased she was. Y ella estaba encantada. When she saw the porridge. When significa cuando. She saw, ella vio, the porridge. La, que significa porridge, avena. On the table, en la mesa. If she had been a well brought up little girl, if she, if significa si, si ella had been, si ella hubiera sido a well brought up little girl, una niña bien educada, she would have waited, she, ella, would have, habría waited, esperado. Ella habría esperado. Till the bears came. Till significa hasta. Hasta que los osos, the bears came, hasta que los osos vinieran a casa. Till the bears came home. And then, y entonces, perhaps, tal vez, they would have asked her to breakfast. Entonces, tal vez, ellos le hubieran pedido que desayunara. They would have asked. Ellos le hubieran pedido. Ask her, a ella. They would have asked her. Ellos le hubieran pedido a ella to breakfast. En este caso, to breakfast es un verbo porque está antecedido por la palabra to. O sea que ya no es desayuno, sino desayunar. Entonces, tal vez, ellos le hubieran pedido que desayunara. But she was an imprudent, rude little girl, and so she set about helping herself. Pero ella was, el pasado de is, que significa era. Pero ella era una imprudente, an imprudent, rude. Rude significa grosera. Little girl, pequeña niña. Pero ella era una imprudente, grosera niña. And so she set about helping herself. Y entonces ella decidió servirse a sí misma. First she tasted the porridge for the great big bear, and that was too hot for her. Next she tasted the porridge for the middle-sized bear, but that was too cold for her. Ya sabemos el antiguo vocabulario. sobre los tamaños de los osos. Ahora vamos a introducir otro vocabulario. Tasted, probó, hot, caliente, y cold, que significa frío. Ya sabemos entonces que Ricitos de Oro entró y habían tres tazones con tres avenas, que una estaba caliente y que la otra estaba fría. A ver. First she tasted the porridge. First significa primero. She tasted, ella probó the porridge, la avena. Primero ella probó la avena of the Great Big Bear. ¿Quién es Great Big Bear? El oso grande. Primero ella probó la avena del oso grande. And that was too hot. Y estaba muy caliente. Too hot significa muy caliente. For her. And it was too hot for her. Y estaba muy caliente para ella. Next, she tasted the porridge. She tasted the porridge. Ella probó la avena of the middle-sized bear, del osito mediano. But that was too cold for her. Pero estaba muy fría. Too cold significa muy fría. For her, para ella. And then she went to the porridge of the little wee bear and tasted. And that was neither too hot nor too cold, but just right. And she liked it so well that she ate it all up, for every bite. Vamos a introducir la palabra ate, que significa comió. Es el pasado de eats, que significa comer. And then she went to the porridge of the little wee bear. And then, y entonces, she went to the porridge. Ella tomó. Aquí dice she went, que significa literalmente ella fue, pero en este sentido quiere decir tomó the porridge of the little wee bear, la avena del pequeño osito. And tasted, y la probó. And that was neither too hot nor too cold. Y estaba ni muy caliente ni muy frío. En inglés se dice neither or nor. Neither too hot, ni muy caliente, nor too cold, ni muy frío. But just right, sino que estaba justo en el punto. And she liked it. Y a ella le gustó. Liked es el pasado del verbo like, que significa gustar. Y a ella le gustó. So well that she ate it up every bite. Así que se lo comió hasta el último bocado. Every bite, cada bocado. Then Goldilocks, who was tired, for she had been catching butterflies instead of running on her errand, sat down in the chair of the great big bear, but that was too hard for her. Then Goldilocks, who was tired, tired significa cansada, sat down significa se sentó, y hard significa dura o duro. Goldilocks, who was tired for she had been catching butterflies. Goldilocks estaba cansada. For, en este caso, for significa because. Because es porque. Porque she had been catching flies. Porque había estado capturando o cazando mariposas. Butterfly significa mariposas. Catching significa cazando o capturando. Instead of running on her errand, en vez de ir errante. Sat down in the chair of the great big bear. Se sentó en la silla. Sabemos que silla es chair. Of the great big bear. Y ya sabemos que great big bear es el oso grande. But that was too hard for her. Pero estaba muy dura para ella. And then she sat down on the chair of the middle-sized bear, and that was too soft for her. But when she sat down in the chair of the little wee bear, that was neither too hard nor too soft, but just right. Vamos a introducir ahora la palabra soft, que significa suave. And then she sat down in a chair of the middle-sized bear. Y entonces se sentó en la silla del oso mediano. And that was too soft, que significa too, muy, muy suave. Y estaba muy suave for her, para ella. But when she sat down in the chair of the little wee bear, pero, but significa pero, when she sat down, cuando ella se sentó, in the chair, en la silla, of the little wee bear, en la silla del pequeño osito, that was neither too hard nor too soft, but just right. Dijimos anteriormente que neither nor significa ni uno ni lo otro. That was neither too hard. No estaba ni muy dura nor too soft. Ni muy suave. But just right. Sino justo como a ella le gustaba. Just right. So she seated herself in it and there she sat till the bottom of the chair came out. And down she came, plump upon the ground, and that made her very cross, for she was a bad-tempered little girl. Y entonces se sentó hasta que el fondo de la silla se rompió o se salió. Till the bottom significa el fondo, of the chair, de la silla, came out, se salió. And down she came, y se fue abajo. Plump upon the ground, se desplomó al piso. Ground significa piso. And that made her very cross. Y eso la enfureció. For she was bad-tempered little girl. For significa because. Porque she was bad-tempered. Porque ella tenía mal temperamento. Goldilocks went upstairs into the bedchamber in which the three bears slept, and first she lay down upon the bed of the great big bear, but it was too high at the head for her. Vamos a introducir ahora el vocabulario bedchamber, que significa dormitorio, y lay down. Y ahora sabemos que Goldilocks está acostada en el dormitorio. Goldilocks went upstairs. Ricitos de Oro fue arriba. Into the bedchamber, al dormitorio. In which the three bears slept. En donde los tres ositos dormían. At first she lay down upon the bed of the great big bear. And first significa y primero. She lay down. Ella se acostó upon the bed of the great big bear. Sobre, upon significa sobre. The bed of the great big bear. La cama del oso grande. But that was too high at the head for her. Pero el espaldar estaba muy alto. And next she lay down upon the bed of the middle-sized bear, and that was too high at the foot for her. And then she lay down upon the bed of the little wee bear, and that was neither too high at the head nor at the foot, but just right. And next she lay down. Y entonces se acostó upon the bed of the middle-sized bear, sobre la cama del osito mediano. And then she lay down upon the bed of the little wee bear. Y entonces se acostó sobre la cama del osito pequeño. And that was neither too high at the head nor at the foot, but just right. Ya dijimos lo que significa neither or nor. Y entonces no era ni muy alta en la cabecera ni en los pies. But just right, sino lo justo, lo correcto. And next she lay down upon the bed of the middle-sized bear, and that was too high. And that was too high at the foot for her. And then she lay down upon the bed of the little bear, and that was neither too high at the head nor at the foot, but just right, and fell asleep. Y entonces se acostó sobre la cama del osito mediano, y era muy alta en los pies para ella. And then she lay down upon the bed of the little weaver. Y entonces acostó sobre la cama del osito pequeño. And that was neither too high at the head nor at the foot. Y no era ni muy alta ni muy pequeña en la cabecera. But just right. And she fell asleep. Sino justo lo correcto. Y se durmió. By this time the three bears thought the porridge would be cool enough for them to eat in properly, so they came home to breakfast. Now, careless, Goldilocks had left the spoon of the great big bear standing in his porridge. By this time the three bears thought the porridge would be cool enough. By this time, para esta hora, the three bears, los tres osos, thought their porridge would be cool enough. Pensaron. Thought es el pasado de think, significa pensar. Thought, pensaron. Their porridge would be cool. Su avena estaría fría. For them to eat, para que ellos se la pudieran comer. So they came home to breakfast. Así que fueron a la casa a desayunar. Now, careless, Goldilocks had left the spoon of the great big bear standing of his porridge. Muy descuidada, Goldilocks, Ricitos de Oro, had left the spoon, había dejado la cuchara of the great big bear, del oso grande, standing in his porridge, parada en su avena. Somebody has been at my porridge, said the great big bear in his great rough gruff voice. Then the middle-sized bear looked at his porridge and saw the spoon was standing in two. Somebody has been at my porridge. Alguien ha estado en mi avena, said the great big bear in his great rough voice. Dijo el oso grande con su voraz voz. Then the middle-sized bear looked at his porridge and saw the spoon was standing in two. Entonces el oso mediano looked at his porridge, vio su avena, and saw the spoon was standing in two. Vio que la cuchara también estaba parada en su avena. Somebody has been at my porridge, said the middle-sized bear in his middle-sized voice. Alguien ha estado en mi avena, dijo el oso mediano con su mediana voz. Then the little wee bear looked at his, and there was the spoon in the porridge bowl, but the porridge was all gone. Entonces el pequeño osito looked at his, miró a la suya, miró su bowl, and there was the spoon in the porridge bowl, y estaba la cuchara en su avena, but the porridge was all gone, pero ya no había más avena. Somebody has been at my porridge and has eaten it all up, said the little wee bear in his little wee voice. Alguien ha estado en mi avena and has eaten it up, y se la ha comido toda, said the little wee bear in his little wee voice. dijo el pequeño osito con su pequeñita voz. Upon this, the three bears seen that someone has entered in their house and eaten up the little wee bear's breakfast, began to look about them. Now the careless Goldilocks had not put the hard cushion straight when she rose from the chair of the great big bear. Vamos a introducir ahora la palabra looked, que es mirar, y en este caso es buscar. Y cushion, que significa almohadón o cojín. Upon this, the three bears seen that nobody had entered the house. Viendo los tres ositos que alguien había entrado a la casa, and eaten up the little wee bear's breakfast, y se había comido el desayuno de los ositos, began to look about them, comenzaron a buscar. Now, the careless Goldilocks had not put the hard cushion straight, pero entonces la descuidada Ricitos de Oro no había puesto el cojín derecho. When she rose from the chair of the great big bear, cuando ella se levantó de la silla del oso grande. Somebody has been sitting in my chair, said the great big bear in his great rough voice, and the careless Goldilocks has squeezed down the soft cushion of the middle-sized bear. Somebody has been sitting in my chair. Alguien se ha estado sentando en mi silla, said the great big bear in his great rough voice, dijo el gran oso con su gran voz. And the careless Goldilocks had squeezed down of the soft cushion of the middle-sized bear. Y la descuidada, Ricitos de Oro, Somebody has been sitting in my chair, said the middle-sized bear in his middle-sized voice. Alguien se ha sentado en mi silla, dijo el osito mediano con su mediana voz. Somebody has been sitting in my chair and it is broken now, said the little wee bear in his little wee voice. Alguien se ha sentado en mi silla y ahora está rota, dijo el osito pequeño con su pequeña voz. The three bears went upstairs into the bedchamber. Now Goldilocks had pulled the pillow of the great big bear out of its place. Somebody has slept in my bed, said the great big bear. The three bears went upstairs into their chambers. Los tres osos fueron arriba a sus aposentos, a sus cuartos, a sus habitaciones. Now, Goldilocks had pulled the pillow of the great big bear. Ahora, Ricitos de Oro había alado la almohada del oso grande, fuera de su lugar, out of its place. Somebody has slept in my bed, said the great big bear. Alguien ha dormido en mi cama, dijo el oso grande. And Goldilocks had pulled the bolster of the middle-sized bear out of its place. Somebody has slept in my bed, said the middle-sized bear in his middle-sized voice. Y Goldilocks había alado las almohadas del oso mediano fuera de su lugar. Somebody has slept in my bed. Alguien ha dormido en mi cama, said the middle-sized bear in his middle-sized voice. Dijo el mediano oso con su mediana voz. But when the little wee bear came to look at his bed, there was Goldilocks. Pero cuando el pequeño oso fue a ver a su cama, ahí estaba Ricitos de Oro. Somebody has been lying in my bed. And here she is still. Alguien ha estado durmiendo en mi cama y todavía está aquí, said the little wee bear in his little wee voice. Dijo el pequeño osito con su pequeña voz. Now Goldilocks had her in her sleep, the great rough gruff voice of the great big bear, but she was so fast asleep that it was no more to her than the roaring of wind or the rumbling of thunder. Ahora Goldilocks había escuchado en su sueño la gran estruendosa voz del gran oso. But she was so asleep that it was no more to her than the roaring of wind or the rumbling of thunder. Pero ella estaba tan dormida que no era más que el rugir del viento y el retumbar del trueno. And she had heard the middle-sized voice of the middle-sized bear, but it was only as if she had heard someone speaking in dream. But when she heard the little wee voice of the little wee bear, it was so sharp and so thrilled that it awakened her at once. Y ella había escuchado la voz del oso mediano, but it was only as if she had heard someone speaking in dream. Pero era como si hubiera escuchado a alguien en sus sueños. But when she heard the little wee voice of the little wee bear, pero cuando escuchó la pequeñita voz del pequeñito osito, it was so sharp and so shrill that it awakened her at once. Pero cuando escuchó la vocecita del pequeño osito, era tan estridente que la despertó de una vez. When she saw the three bears on the side of the bed, she stumbled herself out at the other and ran to the window. Now the window was open because the bear, like good, tidy bears as they were, always opened their bedchamber window when they got up in the morning. Cuando ella vio los tres osos al lado de su cama, ella se cayó de lado y corrió a la ventana. Ahora la ventana estaba abierta porque los osos, como buenos osos, ellos siempre la tenían abierta, la ventana de su cuarto, cuando ellos se levantaban en la mañana. Frightened, little Goldilocks jumped and ran into the wood and was lost there, or found her way out of the wood and got whipped for being a bad girl, and playing truant, no one can say, but the three bears never saw anything more for her. Muy asustada, Goldilocks, o Ricitos de Oro, saltó, and ran into the wood, y corrió hacia el bosque, and was lost there, y estaba perdida allá, o found her way out of the wood, o encontró su salida del bosque, and got whipped for being bad girl, o fue azotada. Nadie lo puede saber. But the three bears never saw anything more of her. Pero los tres ositos nunca supieron más de ella. Ahora, escucha la lectura completa en inglés y trata de recordar todo el vocabulario que aprendiste. Once upon a time, there were three bears who lived together in a house of their own in a wood. One of them was a little wee bear, and one was a middle-sized bear, and the other was a great big bear. They had each a bowl for their porridge, a little bowl for the little bear, and a middle-sized bowl for the middle-sized bear, and a great bowl for the great big bear. And they had each a chair to sit in, a little chair for the little wee bear, and a middle-sized chair for the middle-sized bear, and a great chair for the great big bear. A little bed for the little wee bear, and a middle-sized bed for the middle-sized bear, and a great bed for the great big bear. One day, after they had made the porridge for their breakfast and poured it into the porridge bowl, they walked out into the wood while the porridge was cooling, that they might not burn their mouth by beginning too soon, for they were polite, well brought up bears. And while they were away, a little girl called Goldilocks, who lived at the other side of the wood and had been sent on an errand by her mother, passed by the house and looked in at the window. And then she peeped in at the keyhole, for she was not at all a well-brought-up little girl. Then, seeing nobody in the house, she lifted the latch. The door was not fastened, because the bears were good bears who did nobody any harm, and never suspected that nobody would harm them. So Goldilocks opened the door and went in. And well pleased she was when she saw the porridge on the table. If she had been a well-brought-up little girl, she would have waited till the bears came home, and then perhaps they would have asked her to breakfast. But she was an imprudent, rude little girl, and so she set about helping herself. First she tasted the porridge of the great big bear, and that was too hard for her. Next she tasted the porridge of the middle-sized bear, but that was too cold for her. And then she went to the porridge of the little wee bear and tasted, and that was neither too hot nor too cold. Then Goldilocks, who was tired, for she had been catching butterflies instead of running on her errand, sat down in the chair of the great big bear, but that was too hard for her. And then she sat down in the chair of the middle-sized bear, and that was too soft for her. But when she sat down in the chair of the little wee bear, that was neither too hard nor too soft, but just right. So she seated herself in it, and there she sat till the bottom of the chair came out, and down she came, plump upon the ground, and that made her very cross, for she was a bad-tempered little girl. Goldilocks went upstairs into the bedchamber, in which the three bears slept, and first she lay down upon the bed of the great big bear, but that was too high at the head for her. And next she lay down upon the bed of the middle-sized bear, and that was too high at the foot for her. And then she lay down upon the bed of the little wee bear, and that was neither too high at the head nor at the foot, but just right. And next she lay down upon the bed of the middle-sized bear, and that was too high at the foot for her. And then she lay down upon the bed of the little wee bear, and that was neither too high at the head nor at the foot, but just right. And she fell asleep. By this time the three bears thought their porridge would be cool enough for them to eat it properly, so they came home to breakfast. Now, careless Goldilocks had left the spoon of the great big bear standing in his porridge. "Somebody has been at my porridge," said the great big bear in his great rough, gruff voice. Then the middle-sized bear looked at his porridge and saw the spoon was standing in two. "Someone has been at my porridge," said the middle-sized bear in his middle-sized voice. Then the little wee bear looked at his, and there was the spoon in the porridge bowl, but the porridge was all gone. "Somebody has been at my porridge and has eaten it all up," said the little wee bear in his little wee voice. Upon this, the three bears, seeing that someone had entered their house and eaten up the little wee bear's breakfast, began to look about them. Now, the careless Goldilocks had not put the hard caution straight when she rose from the chair of the great big bear. Somebody has been sitting in my chair, said the great big bear in his great rough gruff voice. And the careless Goldilocks had squatted down the soft cushion of the middle-sized bear. Somebody has been sitting in my chair, said the middle-sized bear in his middle-sized voice. Somebody has been sitting in my chair, and it is broken now, said the little wee bear in his little wee voice. The three bears went upstairs into their bedchamber. Now Goldilocks has pulled the pillow of the great big bear out of its place. Somebody has slept in my bed, said the great big bear. And Goldilocks had pulled the bolster of the middle-sized bear out of its place. Somebody has slept in my bed, said the middle-sized bear in his middle-sized voice. But when the little wee bear came to look at his bed, there was Goldilocks. Somebody has been lying in my bed, and here she is still, said the little wee bear in his little wee voice. Now Goldilocks had heard in her sleep at the great rough gruff voice of the great big bear, but she was so fast asleep that it was no more to hear than the roaring of the wind or the rumbling of thunder. And she had heard the middle-sized voice of the middle-sized bear, but it was only as if she had heard someone speaking in a dream. But when she heard the little wee voice of the little wee bear, it was so sharp and so shrill that it awakened her at once. When she saw the three bears on one side of the bed, she tumbled herself out at the other and ran to the window. Now the window was open because the bears, like good tidy bears as they were, always opened their bedchamber's window when they got up in the morning. Frightened little Goldilocks jumped and ran into the wood and was lost there, or found her way out of the wood and got whipped for being a bad girl and playing truant, no one can say, but the three bears never saw anything more of her.